Yeah, I got it. Today's game is brought to you by the Acadia Music Fest. Mark your calendar for Saturday, October 28th to catch local and regional talents at Acadia Plantation Town Center in Thibodaux. For the latest news on this fall's lineup, visit acadiamusicfest.net.
Pat Kennelly Diamond at Alumni Field in Hammond on the campus of Southeastern Louisiana. All right. Okay. All right. Pat Kennelly Diamond at Alumni Field on the campus of Southeastern University as we get set for baseball. The Holy Cross Tigers, the home team against St. Thomas Aquinas this evening. Here is the batting order for the visiting Falcons of St. Thomas Aquinas under the direction of Barrett Morgan with a record of 5-1 coming in. Champ Artigue's returning star at shortstop. Sam Smith is the catcher. Trey Malazzo, the DH. Alex Egan, the pitcher. Donnie Roberts, the first baseman. Kyle King is the left fielder. Luke Sweeney is at second base. Jacob Becerra plays right field. And Brandon Tallow is the center fielder. Michael Dixon will play third base and will not bat in the lineup. Against the Tigers, left-handed pitcher Ian Buras. The numbers on Buras on the year, Danny, not imposing. We saw him last year against St. Thomas Aquinas. He pitched the final inning in a 2-0 loss in the game here. His numbers a bit deceiving because Holy Cross has faced very good competition.
They've played a great schedule. One thing that jumps out at you, 10 strikeouts in just 6 innings pitched. So obviously he has the ability to put guys away, needs to command the zone, try to get Holy Cross into the dugout quickly. That's one thing I know Cass Harge, the head coach for the Tigers, is looking for here tonight, trying to get off to a little bit better start than they've been doing.
No doubt. And let's take a look at the weather for this evening's contest. It has been a little bit of a concern coming in, but no real concern. At this point, it's a bit humid, it's cloudy, rain is possible. We've had a little bit of a sprinkle previously. And the temperature, 68 degrees. The wind is a bit of a factor out of the southeast at 10, blowing across toward left field as we're set to get it started here this evening. And leading it off for the Falcons will be the left-handed hitting shortstop, Champ Artigue's first pitch of the game, and we're underway with a strike call right on time. No balls and a strike to Artigue's, who will be followed by Smith and then Malazzo against Buras, who got the first pitch over. On the ground toward third, should be an easy chance for Clayton. Danny, we get our first look at this new infield. Artificial surface, you're going to get the true hops.
You get the true hops. It's an infielder's dream. Like I was saying earlier before the game when we were talking about it, if you can't catch a ground ball in the turf infield, you can't catch a ground ball. This is really a delight to play on. True hops, whatever you think the ball is going to do or supposed to do, that's usually what's going to happen. So it's just a great place to play defense.
Sam Smith takes a hot one outside for a ball. The catcher for the Falcons with his maroon jersey at 312. 3 driven in on the season. Out of play right side. We're even at a ball and a strike. Ian Buras, the left-handed hurler, as mentioned, saw him in the game last year. He's a senior now. And if Buras can throw strikes, he'll be tough. Throwing strikes here, and he's ahead 1-2.
He's doing a nice job of commanding pitches, staying in the zone, and that's what you want to do. Let your defense play. It's a big park. You got turf on the infield, and it's a big park in the outfield. So throw strikes, let him play defense.
Ahead of Smith, 1-2. Buras delivers, and it's 2-2. Outfield has him shaded the opposite way. The intriguing thing about this playing surface is that the outfield remains natural grass.
Yep, turf infield, grass in the outfield. It's a budgetary type thing. A lot of people are doing that.
Threw the fastball by him. Good location, outer portion and at the knees. And that's out number 2 and the first strikeout recorded by Ian Buras.
A little bit cheaper, you know, to do it this way, keep the grass in the outfield and put the turf on the infield. It's not the easiest thing to do from a budget standpoint, but a lot of programs, high school and college, are going to these turf fields.
Trey Malazzo offers at the first and beats it foul at the plate. Malazzo, powerful left-handed swinger. Behind in the count 0-1, Malazzo's numbers on the year, 316, and he's driven in 5 runs already. The senior waits and took it just off the plate. Even up at a ball and a strike. Left-handed pitcher facing a couple of left-handed hitters at the top of the order. Malazzo in the air out of play, and it's a ball and 2 strikes. So Buras throwing strikes and getting ahead early.
Hey, he's done a nice job, and that's what Cass Hodges was looking for. And he wants to be able to play the game fast offensively, and he said it's just been tough to do that when you've been down right from the get-go in a game. So he would love to get in the dugout with a 0 on the board.
Showed him the curveball. It's up, and it's 2 balls and 2 strikes. And Buras ready to work as soon as He catches the ball.
Gotta like that as a defensive player. Those pitchers that get it and they're ready to throw it.
The 2-2. Jammed him. Fouled into the seats just off to our left. And the count holds at 2-2. Good look at Trey Milazzo, the senior. Readjusting his batting gloves. St. Thomas Aquinas, the visiting team in this game, after serving as the home team when they played each other a year and a day ago. Two-two. And now it's full. Three balls and two strikes with Egan on deck.
Oh, Ian Buras needs to throw a strike right here. 3-2 count. Two outs, nobody on. You don't want to give St. Thomas Aquinas any life right here. Whenever you've got two outs and nobody on, you don't want to walk a guy. You want to go get him.
Lots of hitting room down the right field line and to right center. This is toward the first baseman. Now he retreats to the bag smartly as the second baseman, Tiffany, throws him out. Smart play by Toscano. Read it right, got back to the bag. Nothing across for the Falcons in the top of the first, and the Tigers are coming to bat here in the bottom of the first. And that's a smart move by the first baseman. He realized that his second baseman could make the play.
Well, that's exactly the read that Toscano needed to make there. If he can't get to the baseball and get back to the bag himself, he's got to let the second baseman try to make the play as he did right there. Very smart heads-up play by Mickey over there at first base to let that one go and get back to the base, because if he goes and gets that one and he can't get back, nobody's going to be there.
Good start for the Tigers. We've had trouble getting people out in the first inning this year. They do so here, and now they get a chance to go on offense. Here's the batting order for the Holy Cross Tigers, presented by First NBC Bank. Cole Nalesnik, returning starter, the catcher. Ashton Goldring in center field. Frank Tiffany at second base. Kyle Clayton outstanding at third base. It's Alex Wiltz at shortstop. Chris Collette, the DH. Ethan Mitchler in right field. It's Mickey Toscano at first base. Chase Rosano is the left fielder, and Ian Buras on the mound, as we've seen, and they will oppose a very good right-handed pitcher for St. Thomas Aquinas in Alex Egan. Well, Egan has been their man thus far this year. Those are very imposing numbers.
0.75 ERA, 2-0 record, undefeated on the mound early here in the year, 13 strikeouts, only two walks. That's what really jumps out. That's the key at the high school level, really any level, is not giving those free passes, making offenses earn whatever they get, and that's the name of the game, throwing the ball over the dish, not being afraid to let your defense make plays for you. But he's got the ability, 13 strikeouts, to just put guys away on his own.
Taking his warm-up tosses, and again, very good on the year. He'll face Nalesnik, Goldring, and Tiffany to get things started for the Tigers in the bottom of the first inning. Again, it has to feel a little bit strange for the Falcons to be a visiting team here. Cole Nalesnik will stand in. Lefty swinger and a good hitter, taking it down for a ball. As mentioned, Egan will be around the plate, as the numbers suggest. So we talked about aggressiveness by Holy Cross early, and there's why. Numbers are down, having faced good pitching this year. They want to get it going, but no need to be aggressive here, as Egan is out of the zone with the first two.
Well, Nalesnik's job here in the leadoff spot is to get on base, whatever it takes.
Well, he's offering at the 2-0 pitch, and it's 2-1. A little bit surprising out of the box for a leadoff batter. But again, the aggressiveness we spoke of, Cass Hargis wants to get his guys going. This kid's a good hitter. Average doesn't reflect it yet. They just need to get a couple of knocks, and things will turn around for them. 2-1, and before that time, from the home plate umpire. Both pitchers wanting to work very quickly. Change up high, 3-1. Fans continuing to file in on what's turned out to be a pleasant evening. Let's hope it stays that way, as a swing and a miss. Runs the count full to 3-2. Fastball, as Cass Hargis looks on, who's in familiar territory here at Southeastern Louisiana, where he was a freshman All-American in 2008. Ball four to Nalesnik. Leadoff man is aboard. Good start for the Tigers.
Good job by Cole of knowing the zone, staying there, finding his way on base, and that's what's really going to allow this Tiger offense to do what they want to do as far as putting pressure on defenses, when they can get leadoff men on to start an inning.
And a courtesy runner for the Tigers as they'll run Adrian Aguiar at first base. Aguiar running at first for Nalesnik, and Ashton Goldring will be the hitter. And immediately throwing over is Egan. Another snap throw, that's closer. Pretty quick move by Egan. Leadoff hitters typically are big parts of teams running games. And of course, with the courtesy runner, even more so. Of course, you don't see many catchers hitting leadoff. Showing bunt early and getting it down. Nice job. Play to first. Sacrifice works into scoring position to Lesnick. Or rather, the courtesy runner Aguiar with Goldring having laid down the bunt. Willie Cross playing station to station baseball, trying to get something against Egan. They know that runs will likely be at a premium against him.
Yeah, he's a good arm, and this is the way they want to play, though. They want to try to set the table, get guys in scoring position, and see if their hitters in the middle of the order can deliver.
Frank Tinfany takes a strike call, a breaking ball. Left-handed hitter. Tinfany's one of the few Tigers off to a very good start. He's got 8 RBI already with his 304 average in just 9 games. In the dirt, nice play by Smith to smother it. And that keeps Aguiar at second base. Straight away for the hitter. Defensively around the outfield. Slightly to pull on the infield. The 1-1. And now it is 2 balls and a strike. Of course, they had Hunter Stanley last year. He's now at Meridian.
Yeah, he was really good. Really good arm. One of the keys to their state championship a year ago for sure.
2-1. That's a strike, and it's 2-2. In fact, Meridian has Hunter Stanley, and they've also got Connor Kosay there, right?
Yeah, two of the best arms in Southeast Louisiana last year ended up at Meridian Junior College, so kind of interesting, but both of those really nice arms are playing junior college baseball at Meridian.
Long look and time called. Egan freezing the runner. Smart move by Tinfany to call time. Good look at Egan as he peers in. And that's lifted into left center. It's going to drop for a base hit. Runner had to make it get down. And now it's bobbled, and he will score on his way to second. Safely is Tinfany. That will be an RBI single and a 1-0 lead for Holy Cross, taking second on the bobble and left.
Nice job there by Frank Tinfany. Going the other way. You knew that was down. And first run across the board here tonight goes to the Holy Cross Tigers. That ball looked like it was down and away. Did a nice job of staying on it, going where it was pitched. He sees the bobble, moves into scoring position, and the Tigers are up 1-0 here in the bottom of the first.
Give him an RBI. He never stopped running, but the error allows the runner to reach second base, and there's a strike called. It's 0-1, so it should be a base hit, RBI and error. And Kyle Clayton bats, the cleanup hitter, as Egan finds himself behind for a rare occasion. Oh-1. Breaking ball beat foul. 0-2. It's got to be an error on a left fielder. They have not recorded that on the scoreboard here, but clearly the runner wouldn't be at second base were it not for that. No balls and 2 strikes. Fastball away, 1-2.
Kyle Clayton's been a real bright spot in this Holy Cross Tiger lineup thus far, hitting .421. Some gaudy numbers so far, and hit a grand slam up in Monroe this past weekend. So this is one of their better hitters at the plate right here with another runner in scoring position.
Time called again. Egan wanted to work quickly with nobody on. He's been much more deliberate with runners on base. High with his fastball, and it's 2-2.
Kyle Clayton heading to Nickel State next year. So he'll play for the Colonels down in Thibodeau. Seth Thibodeau, the head coach, getting a good one.
Two balls, two strikes. And the pitch to Clayton. And he swings and hits it high and deep to left. Left fielder back near the track at the wall. And that ball is going to be off the wall. A runner's going to score. Rounding second inning for third is Clayton. The throw there is not in time. It's an RBI triple for Kyle Clayton. And Holy Cross has taken a 2-0 lead. We had to wait for that one to come down. It was hit very high, and it hit up off that wall. Nearly got out of here.
Very close to that yellow stripe at the top of the wall. Just didn't go out of the park, but it was hit well. You could see it off the bat that he got into it nicely. Drove the baseball well there out to deep left field. Kyle Clayton, one of the real bright spots in this Holy Cross lineup right now. He's really swinging it.
Great start for the Tigers. Are up two already and still only one out. And Alex Wiltz, the shortstop, at the plate. They're in at first and third. Pitch is down for a ball to Wiltz, shortstop.
This is the kind of start, Ken, that Cass Harge has really wanted to get off to. So things thus far in the ball game, even though it's very, very early here in the first inning, are going the Tigers' way.
And a safety squeeze is popped up. And the first baseman, Roberts, makes the catch. Round number two, not the execution you want there.
And he was trying to push it on the right side to try to score the runner from third. Got up underneath it. Pop up to the first baseman there for the second out. See if Holy Cross can get a big two-out hit with Kyle Clayton sitting down there 90 feet away at third base.
Chris Collette swings and taps it foul. The designated hitter for the Tigers. At 231, he has a home run with five driven in. Missed inside off speed, and it's 1-1. RBI single by Timpany, RBI triple by Clayton. And, of course, as always, it starts with a leadoff walk.
Something that you have to stay away from as a pitcher and a defense. They always come back to hurt.
Sink on that one. Good. It's 1-2.
It's a great thing for an offense to get that leadoff man on. It's a tough thing for a pitcher and a defense. Hard to keep him from scoring at this level.
1-2. Just missed the outside edge, 2-2. Good take. Again, don't be deceived by the 4-5 record of Holy Cross. They're very good. It's all about the competition that they've played, which will clearly make them better moving forward. And the 2-2, and a foul back. Horsey hack at that one by Collette. Let's see the power he has with that swing. Holding it 2-2. As Egan is about to make his 25th pitch of the inning. Laboring to get through it. Good breaking ball. Should get him out of it. Catcher has to throw to first. Very high! And he's safe at first base. And a run scores. And Holy Cross leads 3-0 on a throwing error by Smith.
That's why you run on that drop third strike. You can't pout about it. You got to get down the line. You see some of these hitters, they swing and miss, and it's poor, pitiful me. Drop third strike, get down the line as fast as you can. Try to help your team. That's what Collette did right there. You see the mistake by St. Thomas Aquinas, and it leads to a third run for Holy Cross here in the bottom of the first.
Makes it even tougher on Egan, who has to throw more pitches. It's 3-0. Ethan Mitchell of the right fielder bats. Snap throw to first, runner back. Runner breaks immediately, and he steals it easily, but swinging on the pitch. Mitchell fouls it back. You talk about having the base stolen. He not only would have been standing up, he'd have been rounding second. As he went on, really not even on first movement, he just took off.
He had a huge jump there, as you mentioned, had the base taken easily.
Thus draws a snap throw and is back diving in. When you hit the dirt here, you get gravel. Not so much dirt. Breaker missed inside.
Crushed tire that they put down on these turf fields. It's a crushed tire, rubbery material. And you're exactly right. You get that all over yourself when you dive on these turf infields.
Egan, a long look. That's up, and it's two balls and two strikes. As the pitch count continues to mount for Alex Egan here in the first. Another snap throw to first. Runner goes. Popped up. Catcher, first baseman converge. Should be a play. Making the catch is Smith. Inning over, but Holy Cross gets three runs. They do so on two hits with two errors. Strand a runner after one. 3-0 Tigers on the first NBC Bank Rep Showcase. And no strikes. Roberts, 231 with four driven in. Two O pitch. Right down the middle, it's 2-1. And the 2-1. On the ground towards short. Got to come get it. Nice job on the move. Wiltz throws him out. Good play.
Nice job of coming to get the baseball by Wiltz at shortstop for the Tigers. Came and got the hop. Makes the throw on the move. Nice defensive play there on the Tiger infield. And this is important right here. You just put three on the board. You'd love to put a zero up and get right back in the dugout, see if you can add on.
Athanese for a strike call to Kyle King, another returning starter from the state championship team. 200 batter with five RBI. Taps it foul behind the plate. Oh, Buris getting ahead of everyone.
Yeah, he's doing a nice job of pounding the zone. One of the points that we made in the open tonight was that they needed to cut down on the walks that the pitching staff in general has been allowing, and he's doing that so far here tonight, and that's why there's a zero up on the board for St. Thomas Aquinas right now.
Just missed inside edge. Quality pitch on 0-2, though.
Tried to run it in on him, just missed. Thought he had the call.
Nalesnik looks at his wrist. They have that system with the numbers on the wrist to relay the sign from the coach in the dugout. It's a popular method of delivering the pitch sequence to pitchers in high school and college, for that matter. High, and it's 2-2.
That makes it very difficult to pick up signs. They used to be able to pick up signs a lot of times offensively if you had guys in the dugout watching the opposing coach, but when you're calling in numbers and various numbers mean various things, it's hard to pick it up.
Foul tip into the mid, ends the second, bottom half coming, 3-0, Holy Cross. Time now for Traditions, presented by Joseph A. Bank, the new tradition since 1905. There may be no older tradition in high school sports in New Orleans than the Holy Cross Victory Bell, reserved for major accomplishments like state championships. The bell rang last month to celebrate the Tigers' Division I state championship in wrestling. We were there. This was the site. What a tradition. Look at the age of that bell. It's been there for a long time. There's Brother Melchior, the legend. And there's the Tiger salute and their outstanding wrestling program. Kent DeSormo leading the way. Congratulations to Holy Cross. That's quite a tradition, Danny.
It sure is, and that's one of the special things about the New Orleans Catholic League is just the tradition that is based in all those institutions.
Ball missing down and out. 1-0 to Mickey Toscano. It'll be followed by Rosano and Nalesnik. Swing and a miss, 1-1. Now you know that I cover wrestling probably as much as anyone. And Kent DeSormo doesn't coach wrestling. I'm just saying, Eric DeSormo does. Last time I checked, Kent was a jockey. But I knew that was going to happen. It's inevitable when you play the name game. So, Eric, I got you, buddy. 2-1, swing and a miss. It's 2-2. You got to love it. Egan again. He works very quickly with no one on base, Danny.
Yeah, he's another one that gets it and is ready to throw it.
Artigues has to hustle. He'll not have a play. Infield hit for Toscano, who beat it on the ground, runs hard. And one thing you note about this turf infield is it plays kind of slow, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. And that's something that Coach Reiser from SLU was telling us before the game, that the ball will sit on this turf. And here we'll take another look at it. Toscano hustling down the line. Infield single. And Holy Cross once again with a leadoff man on base.
And again, showing bunt, trying to advance the runner, but pulling back is Rosano, ball one.
Really a nice park here at Southeastern. This turf really took it to another level. It was already a nice place, but this turf really has made this an awesome ballpark here in Hammond.
Late on the fastball, it's 1-1.
And in Southeast Louisiana, it's always nice to have turf, especially when you start getting into the summertime.
Move to first, runner back again. And did he pull the bat back? He did. Pitch inside, 2-1. Another snap throw to first. So we're seeing a lot of moves over there, aren't we?
Yeah, they're keeping an eye on Toscano over there. I think he might want to get in motion at some point. And there
he
goes, right there, yep.
So it's 2-2, Rosano. Got a pitch to hit, wasn't able to put it in play. Returning to first is Toscano.
You can trace coaching staffs on both sides tonight back to Southeastern here at SLU. Played here for Coach Artigues. That's the type of baseball that they play. They're aggressive. That's where they got it from. And in the offense, whether it's St. Thomas Aquinas or Holy Cross, they're going to resemble each other in a lot of ways.
Not going, and a swing and a miss. He struck him out. So went up in the zone to get Rosano. For out number one here in the second inning, the second strikeout recorded by Alex Eagle.
Here's strike three, a high hard one. He chased it up in the zone, couldn't catch up to it. They look good up there. You just can't do a whole lot with them.
Cole Nalesnik started that three-run first with a walk. Swing and a miss. Runner goes. Throw down is bouncing, and he is safe at second base. A stolen base for Mickey Toscano to get himself into scoring position with one out. Holy Cross playing aggressive baseball, as we suggested they must.
That's what they wanted to do. They're up 3-0, so you can kind of take some chances. Toscano showing nice speed there on the stolen base.
His second stolen base of the year. This is high from Egan. Count is equal. Had a ball and a strike. Lesnick holding that bat very low down by the handle. 1-1. Strike called. It's 1-2. And now most hitters do that these days. Of course, when you get to the major league level or professional level, you use wooden bats. You still see some guys choke up a little bit, in particular when they're down in the count. But with these bats, they just pick the one that suits them and thus hold it down as low as you can and get as much power as you can. 1-2. Threw it by him. So two consecutive strikeouts recorded by Egan, who's settling in now, his third strikeout of the game.
That's the case a lot of times with starting pitchers. If you don't get them early, they get tough to get to because they get better as the game goes on. Egan, one of the better arms that we'll see this year, is doing just that. He's settling in, making some key pitches with Toscano in scoring position.
Ashton Goldring, sack bunt his first time. Hits it in the air, very high, short right center field. Second baseman out, has a play, and making the catch is Sweeney. Inning is over with no runs and a hit. Second runner stranded by Holy Cross. 3-0 Tigers after two. This portion of the BC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by the Acadia Music Fest, Saturday, October 28th in Thibodaux. For the latest news on this fall's lineup, visit acadiamusicfest.net. First pitch at the top of the third, sails high and wide to Luke Sweeney. Bottom three in the order for STA. Becerra and Tallow to follow against Buras. And this is fouled right side, chased by the right fielder, and not going to get there, as it lands just out of the reach of the Holy Cross right fielder, Mitchler, and it's a ball and a strike. Buras, only 26 pitches in two innings, so he's set them down in order thus far and looked very good doing so.
Doing a nice job of pounding the zone, absolutely.
Hot one is over but low, and it's 2-1.
Even when he misses, his misses are close. Doing a nice job of commanding all of his pitches.
Way outside and high, so now he's falling behind the leadoff man. Three balls and a strike. They play this hitter. It's an opposite field hitter all the way. Give him a bunch of the left field line. Way outside, so a leadoff walk issued to Luke Sweeney here in the third.
Well, that'll kick start an offense. So we'll see how St. Thomas plays it here, but they like to play aggressive. Buehrs being a left-hander will help with that. They'll be able to keep him a little bit more true in the running game, but that's what they need. That's what St. Thomas wants. They want that leadoff man on.
Jacob Becerra will bat. Tall right-handed swinger and a good one. Right fielder of the Falcons. Took this high, so suddenly Buehrs having trouble finding the zone. Becerra off to a good start at 368. He has driven in three runs. Lights have taken full effect. Pat Kennelly Diamond, Alumni Field. Shows bunt early, pulls it back. He's taking all the way. 2-0. Just showing bunt there with a pitcher that's struggling to find the zone.
That was probably a take all the way. Just trying to see if they can keep him rattled right here to start the third inning.
On 2-0. Token moved to first. Beyond the right center field fence, the lights of Strawberry Stadium shining brightly tonight as well. Shows bunt again and pulls the bat back and takes ball three. So it is 3-0. The Southeastern Lions have started spring football practice over at Strawberry Stadium. And you know the take sign is on for Becerra here. On 3-0. Pulled it back, took a ball. It's two consecutive walks issued by Buehrs, and suddenly the Falcons have something brewing in the third as Champ Artigues will bat and we'll get a visit to the mound.
And Phil White's gonna go out there, the pitching coach for the Tigers, and talk things over with Buehrs, try to settle him that. Down, there's a good look at Strawberry Stadium, the lights you were just mentioning. That's just on the other side of the right field wall. But Phil White out there on the mound right now, talking to Buehrs, settling them down. Can't defend a walk, so we got to settle in here, get back in the zone just like he's been doing all game until this point. We'll see if St. Thomas decides to bunt right here. That could be a possibility, down 3-0. Here in the third, they might say, hey, let's try to bunt two guys in the scoring position. Might try to bunt for a hit. They can do a lot of different things here with two men on and nobody out.
And now Artigues grounded to third his first time. He shows bunt. He does try to bunt it and fouls it. Surprised he's bunting here. 0-1, that's Brandon Tallow batting. So Tallow, not Artigues, but Tallow. Makes sense, obviously, to bunt here. So Brandon Tallow. Behind in the count, 0-1.
Well, just the way these teams play, Ken. They both play this type of baseball. And it's not a surprise at all for them to try to bunt these two guys in the scoring position.
Gets it down, dented it beautifully. Bobble and safe at first. So the error will create the opportunity. Goes as a sacrifice and an error. And the bases are loaded with nobody out.
Well, the other factor that you've got tonight is it's been a light rain mist for most of the afternoon, so this is a wet baseball as he gets that one down on the ground. Just a little bobble there by Buehrs allows him to get through the bag in time, and the bases are loaded with nobody out. And St. Thomas Aquinas, they're right where they want to be.
Now flip the order to Champ Artigues, who grounded the third his first time. Big opportunity, took a hook, and it's down for a ball.
That's one of those situations where if you're Holy Cross, you'd love to just get a ground ball on your infield, try to turn a double play, and you'll give up one run to get two outs just to try to minimize potential damage here in a situation of bases loaded, nobody out.
1-0, and that grazed him, and it's a 3-1 ball game. So it's an RBI for Artigues. Hit by pitch, gets his seventh run driven in. Sweeney scoring, Becerritas moving up to third and Chandler to second. So it's a 3-1 ball game.
Tries to run this one in and gets a little bit of them. Not a whole lot, but just enough. If it touches that uniform, it's a hit by pitch, and that's all that really was. It just grazed them, and that puts the first run on the board for St. Thomas Aquinas.
Is it by the catchers? The bullpen's going to stir for Holy Cross. Killing for time here, Danny.
Yeah, they're giving those guys a chance to get down to that bullpen. The bullpen for the team in the third base dugout is on the other side of the left field wall, right behind the scoreboard here at Southeastern. So it's a little bit of a run to get down there. So smart move there by Nalesnik to go out there and stall just to give him time to get in the pen and get throwing, as Holy Cross finds himself in a pretty big jam right here.
Sam Smith with a chance, took a strike, struck out swinging his first time. So four straight have reached without the benefit of a hit for St. Thomas Aquinas. They're on the board without a hit and with a chance to get much more. Smith late on this one. It's no balls and two strikes.
Well, this is a key spot right here. If Buras can find a way to retire Smith on his own, then that gives you the chance to roll the ground ball and get out of this with a double play.
0-2 the count. Ready once again, the left-hander delivers. Smash to left. That's a base hit. One run is home. Second runner for the plate. He will score. We are tied on a two-run single by Sam Smith.
That's a good job of hitting there by Smith to deliver with the bases loaded and tie this game up. Get something he could turn on. He did a good job of getting his hands above the baseball, lining that one out to left field as two runs score. And the Falcons, with runners at first and second, nobody out, right in the meat of their order. So this is right where they want to be.
So with nobody out, an opportunity for Trey Milazzo. Bunch of possibility here. Grounded to second in the first inning to end the inning. Well, Buras had set them down in order through the first two innings and looked really good doing so, but he just lost the strike zone here, and now he's paying a price.
With the way St. Thomas Aquinas plays right here, do not be surprised to see another bunt attempt.
And there it comes, and there it is. Beautifully done. First baseman and the second baseman covering. Runners advance to second and third with only one out.
Fundamental offensive baseball. First and second, nobody out. Get it on the ground, bunt him over. Got it towards the first baseman, where he had to come up and make the play and advance those runners. Holy Cross having to go get that out, the sure out over there at first base.
Alex Egan popped to the first baseman his first time. Buras chooses to work from the stretch. Breaking ball's a good one. It's 0-1.
Holy Cross infield staying back here. It is only the third inning, so I guess they figure they've got time to come back, even if they would lose the lead, obviously. But Cass Hargis with his defense back. So a ground ball will put St. Thomas Aquinas ahead.
Buras ahead, no balls and two strikes. Breaking ball beat toward third, runner for the plate. He will score. St. Thomas Aquinas takes a 4-3 lead. On the ground out by Egan as he drives in his sixth run of the year. And the Falcons are ahead.
That's just good offensive execution there. Exactly how you draw it up. First and second, nobody out. Sacrifice bunt, get him in the scoring position and find a way to score that guy from third. The chopper there, the Clayton, he had to go across. Good play on his part to go ahead and get that second out at first base. Did not have a play at the plate. St. Thomas Aquinas so far with a four spot here in the top of the third as that one misses up in the zone.
And a runner at third with a chance to add another with a two-out knock by Danny Roberts, who grounded to short in the second. Roberts hard toward left. Diving catch by the shortstop, Wiltz. Saves a run, and the inning is over. Big inning for the Falcons. Four runs on just one hit. They strand a runner. Bottom of the third coming, 4-3. Strike called. It's full 3-2. Hits it hard the other way, slicing and a base hit. So Timpany is 2-for-2. And the Tigers have the leadoff man on for the third consecutive inning.
And that is so important to this offense and trying to respond here specifically in the bottom of the third. Good job of going the other way again. That's the second at bat that Timpany has taken the baseball the other way for a base hit.
Good breaking ball for a strike to Clayton, who hammered one high up off the wall and left for an RBI triple in the first and scored a run.
Quick pickoff move there from Egan. You've got to be quick. On your toes.
As we mentioned earlier, he's quick. Third base side on the ground. It's no balls and two strikes as Egan gets ahead of Clayton with Wiltz waiting on deck. Wasted one away, 1-2. High and away, 2-2.
He missed high and away there, and 1-2 with the fastball. More than likely, he's going to come with some type of wrinkle right here against Clayton. I don't think you're going to see another fastball here.
Another throw to first, chasing the runner back.
Would not be a bad spot if you are trying to pick a spot to run to do it here in a breaking ball count.
Breaking ball in the air, right center, slicing away from the center fielder. That's a base hit. Waiting on it to make sure it got down was Timpany, and he stops at second. Now, if you get a good read on that one, you can certainly be at third base.
Absolutely. Timpany making the smart decision there. If he wasn't sure whether or not the ball was going to be caught, making it fall in.
You doing all right?
But if you see that off the bat, and that's something that you just work on, get a feel for. Pay attention where the outfielders are playing. It's always nice when you know off the bat that that ball is going to fall in. As you mentioned, you could easily go first to third on something like that.
Clayton over toward the dugout now as everybody is visiting with their coaches. Infield at the mound. Holy Cross players over toward their dugout. And the Tigers mounting something here in the fourth. Consecutive hard hit base hits. They've done a really good job against a good pitcher thus far in this game.
Yeah, they're battling. Six hits on the board here in the bottom of the third with nobody out. So you have to be happy if you're Cass Hargis about the way that this club has started the game offensively.
If you're interested in purchasing a DVD copy of today's game, send an email to prep@sportsnola.com or call our offices at 504-681-0120 during normal business hours. You will receive a reply with more information on purchasing DVDs. Leaning a little bit there was Timpany, but gets back. Hunter Alamon is running at first base for Clayton as Wiltz bats with two on, nobody out. And he tried to drag a bunt. It's 0-1. All right, so the idea is to get them advanced. Is that a good idea, or should you just go ahead and square and try to get it down?
Yeah, I mean, the main objective right here is to get these guys in the scoring position so that a base hit can give you the lead. So you want to make sure you're sitting in there, getting a good pitch to handle, get it down on the ground away from the mound, and get these guys moved up. You'd like to bunt it towards the third baseman if you can't make them vacate, and you should easily be able to get those runners moved up.
That's exactly what he does here, but he bunts it too hard to third. He threw it away. And Holy Cross will tie the game on the throwing error. Other runners trying to advance, and he is safe at third. And the Tigers have tied the game 4-4. Play was in front of the first baseman, Roberts, but his throw was wild.
Well, that's exactly what we just mentioned right there. In that situation, you want to try to bunt the ball towards the third baseman. He takes it hard up the first base side. The first baseman was charging. He was right in front of him. And really, a good throw would have got the lead out there at third base. That was the right play, just an errant throw. But you want to try to bunt the baseball. Whenever you're trying to move a guy from second to third, bunt it towards the third base side, make the third baseman come up and make the play. He vacates the bag, and you get that runner moved up pretty easily.
It's the third error of the game for the Falcons already. Pitch on to Caleb, 1-0. And you just knew that was going to happen. Talking to their coaches earlier, they said, hey, the one thing we do, we play really good defense.
They did.
And of course,
that.
Yeah, they did. And here we are with three errors in the fourth inning. Bunt was too hard. Throw would have had him, so it's a fielder's choice and a throwing error. Swing and a miss by Collette. Struck out and reached on that strikeout back in the first, which produced a run on an error.
They did a good job of taking off immediately on that drop third strike.
A ball and a strike. Two on, nobody out, and swung at one. It's a wild pitch, and a run's going to score, and Holy Cross takes a 5-4 lead. Boy, this is happening in the strangest ways, isn't it?
Yeah, both teams. St. Thomas Aquinas with four runs on the board, just one hit. Holy Cross has now retaken the lead at 5-4, and they're doing it on errors and wild pitches.
Yep. So 5-4 Tigers, runner at third. Still nobody out. Egan ready. Egan pitching. Popped and fouled back and out of play. 1-2 the count. In the dirt, boy, that's picked cleanly on the short hop by Smith, and it's 2-2. That was no fun. Right into the glove and the bare hand. Off the catcher's gear with that foul ball, holding it 2-2. Holy Cross up 5-4 in the bottom of the third, a decidedly different game than the one we had here last year, which was a pitcher's duel between Hunter Stanley and Mickey Toscano.
A lot of runs here for just the bottom of the third.
In a lot of different ways. Oftentimes not very pretty. 2-2. Here's a drive to left field. Hit very well. Back toward the wall and off the wall. Scoring easily on the play as Wiltz. Collette checks in at second with a ringing double. Holy Cross 6, St. Thomas Aquinas 4.
Boy, Collette really got into that one, and you know he's a hitter that's done a nice job over his career for Holy Cross, and they're just waiting for him to get going again. And well, that's a good way to get it started. Just absolutely drilled that ball off the very bottom of the wall in left field to give Holy Cross another run. Holy Cross at 3 on the board, still with nobody out here in the bottom of the third. And Cass Hargis has to be excited about the way his team responded to giving up 4 in the top half of the inning.
And here's Ethan Mitchler at the plate, squaring a bunt, taking a ball, popped to the catcher his first time. Just a rough outing for Egan to this point. 1-0 the count. Scoreboard has 5 errors. We have 4 for St. Thomas Aquinas. Has a pop-up foul, and it is dropping foul, and it's now a ball and a strike.
Keeping the pressure on. That's what these offenses like to do on both sides. Sacrifice bunting for a hit, putting guys in motion, hit and run. That's the way they like to play.
One ball, one strike count, and taking a long look now. Ethan will stand back in. First baseman cheats in again, Roberts. Third baseman in a couple of steps. And they look to see if he's bunting. No indication. Oh, Couple of crooked numbers on the board for the Tigers. And a two-run lead here in the third. Hung the breaking ball. Two balls and a strike. Another long look over toward the dugout by Mitchler. Now he's back in. Showed bunt, took a ball. It's 3-1. Toscano on deck. No action in the bullpen as Egan is laboring as he approaches 70 pitches here. Three balls and a strike. Ball four, not close. So two on and still nobody out for the Tigers. The first five have reached here in the third.
That's a tough spot right here for St. Thomas Aquinas. This is a nightmarish type situation as Holy Cross has retaken the lead by two at 6-4, and they're still rolling along here with nobody out. This is no end in sight right now.
Now, another obvious bunt situation. Mickey Toscano singled his first time, stole a base, two on, nobody out. And a pickoff move to second as the shortstop, Artigues, tried to get in behind Collette without any success.
Trying to see if they could steal an out on the bases somewhere just to try to stop this offensive inning for Holy Cross, which is moving along nicely if you're a Tigers fan.
Another move to second. Artigues was just standing there waiting for the ball. You like to time it out if you can. When a guy's standing there waiting on it, base runner will be cognizant. Again, Egan a lot slower with runners on base. Runners going to hit and run. The only play will be to first. He dropped the ball. And this is becoming a nightmare defensive performance for the Falcons.
Yeah, that was a situation where that runner dashing in front of him just kind of confused him a little bit. Over there at second base, Sweeney, and bobbled it. Couldn't recover. And Holy Cross now with bases loaded and nobody out.
Not trying to make excuses, but as you mentioned earlier, you've had the dew and the light rain, and you wonder if it's had any impact on these ground balls with players just unable to get handles. We've seen guys field balls and throw them away, and in other cases, they just drop balls like this. So it's just been a little bit of everything, and the bullpen will stir for the Falcons. Six in a row have reached safely for Holy Cross. The bases are loaded with nobody out. Chase Rizzano struck out swinging in the second. Will have an opportunity. Rizzano hits it slowly to second. Will get a run home. Play is to first for the out. And Holy Cross increases its lead to 7-4. RBI by Rizzano, his first of the year.
Rizzano pulling that one to the right side. Hits it just soft enough to where the run scores and there's no double play opportunity for Holy Cross. In nice position now, second and third. That scored the run and was almost like a bunt, moving those runners up into scoring position.
Len Lesnick with an opportunity. With two runners in scoring position, the infield is in. And he took a fast one for a strike. Nalesnik has walked and scored and struck out.
Well, right here, whenever that infield's in, you're looking for a pitch that you can drive to the outfield. That's what it's all about right here for Cole Nalesnik, is trying to get a pitch that you can get to that outfield grass. If you do that, you should be scoring a run.
Breaking ball dips low, 1-1.
Base hit, fly ball. You just don't want to hit a grounder on the turf. Don't want to strike out. Don't want to pop up on the infield. Try to get something that you can elevate, get out to the outfield.
Breaking ball, good pitch there. Beat foul as you hit the top half of it. Count now to one ball and two strikes. Egan with his Bible verse of Colossians 3:17 on his jersey. Looks on. Bullpen is busy. Trey Malazzo throwing for St. Thomas. This one gets by the catcher. That's a pass ball, and another run scores. And Holy Cross goes up 8-4. So just really struggling defensively.
Yeah,
are the Falcons.
A very shaky performance here defensively, which from speaking with their head coach, Barrett Morgan, before the game, it's not characteristic of this team. He liked the way they play defense. That was one of the bright spots, he felt, of what they've done so far here in 2017, and they're just not having a good night defensively.
Just missing. He laid off. Good take. Count is 2 balls. Make it 3 balls and 2 strikes. On to Lesnick with the runner at third and the infield in. And Goldring on deck. 2 fouls. So we'll get another payoff pitch here. They have the 1 out recorded in the inning and just a whole bunch of defensive mistakes otherwise.
You talk about answering back. Holy Cross giving up the 4 spot in the top of the third, and now they've got 5 so far here in the bottom of the third.
Laid off, and that's ball 4. So trotting down the first base is Nalesnik. And runners will be at the corners, 1 out, and Ashton Goldring will bat. Will be the 9th batter to hit in the inning, and we'll get the proverbial courtesy runner at first base for Holy Cross once again for the catcher, and that again will be number 18, Adrian Aguiar. So Goldring a chance. He has a sacrifice bunt, and he's popped to second. Good look at Aguiar at first.
The catcher, Nalesnik, in that leadoff spot is kind of interesting because if he gets on, which leadoff men tend to do pretty well, that's why they're there, you get to put one of your fastest guys in to courtesy run for him.
And there's a safety squeeze. Run will score. Throw to first for the out. Good job by Goldring to get a run home. And Holy Cross makes it 9-4. On the safety squeeze, Goldring drives in his 4th run of the year.
Good execution there. That's the way Cass Hargis likes to play. He's got to be pretty excited about this offensive performance. Thus far, 9 runs on the board here in the bottom of the third, and they're still batting.
Tiffany, who started the whole thing, will bat again. Remember, his single start of the inning, he scored a run. Takes a strike, it's 0-1.
And the biggest thing I think that he's probably most proud of, if I can speak for him, is the fact that St. Thomas put that 4 spot up in the top half of the inning, and his boys came right back in the bottom here so far with 6, answering right back, completely erased it, and added 2 runs.
High and away, so it's 1-1. And it's fouled back, so it's 1 ball and 2 strikes on Tiffany.
Frankie's done a nice job of going the other way, hitting the ball where it's pitched. If he can do that again here, might get Holy Cross to double-digit runs.
And he couldn't check on the breaking ball. The throw will go to first, and this time it's accurate. And the inning finally ends, but 10 men come to the plate. And Holy Cross plates 6 runs to take a 9-4 lead going to the top of the 4th on the first WC Bank Prep Showcase. New Orleans, Park Lakewood Apartments. 9-4, Tigers on top of the Falcons as we head to the fourth. And Ian Buras, after struggling last inning, looks up and sees himself up by 5 runs now. And he delivers a ground ball back to Buras, who will wheel and deal and get his man. One pitch and one out as he takes care of King to start the fourth inning with his 48th pitch of the game.
That's a good job of Buras getting back out there. Had the tough top half of the third. And getting that first out, settling in. Just had your offense respond for you. They raced that tough top of the third, and you want to just go out there and get right back in the zone and let your defense play with a big lead.
Down and out for a ball, 1-0. Out of play, so it's a ball and a strike on Sweeney, who walked and scored last inning.
Better give a signal over there.
One one pitch. Again, he's late on the fastball. Said that a lot. He's had a pretty good fastball, hasn't he?
He sure has. He does a nice job of using the fastball to spot up, changing speeds. He's done a nice job tonight of running the ball in on hitters' hands. You know, really other than last inning, he's had a nice performance.
High, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Breaking ball hit hard to second, taken care of by Tiffany. 2 gone.
Nice job there, getting that breaking ball over, getting the ground ball on the infield. And Tiffany out there at second base for the second out. That's what you want to do. You've got a 5-run lead now, big lead. Pound that zone if you're Ian Buras, and let him hit ground balls and fly balls all night long.
Jacob Becerra walked and scored in the third. Checked, didn't go on a fastball away. The 1-0 pitch. Has hit him in the foot area. Trots to first base. Second hit batsman by Buras. And Tallow will get a chance.
Got him in that front foot, and that's exactly what he didn't want to do. If you're Holy Cross, anytime we said it earlier, anytime 2 outs, nobody on, slam that door shut. Don't give them any life. Get that in and over.
Fastball high to Brandon Tallow. Sacrificed, reached on an error, scored in the third inning when they played it 4 runs, 2-0. Buras brings it, and that's 3-0. Leadoff man, Artigues on deck. And the catcher, Nalesnik, wants a word with his left-handed hurler. We have seen bullpen action a couple of times for St. Thomas Aquinas with Malazzo not throwing now. You wonder how far Egan can go after that prolonged third inning. And he's high, so a 4-pitch walk to Tallow. 2 on, 2 outs for Champ Artigues, who himself was hit by a pitch and scored a run in the third. He's 0-for-1.
You're kind of starting to build an inning here for St. Thomas Aquinas when they didn't have a whole lot of life. 2 outs and nobody on, and now hit by pitch and a walk, and they're feeling a little bit better about their chances of scoring in this frame.
Toward first, that is a fair ball. Race to the bag, won by the first baseman, Toscano. Inning over with no hits and 2 stranded. They've left 3, bottom of the fourth, 9-4, Holy Cross. Here's a look at the upcoming broadcast schedule brought to you by Park Lakewood Apartments. John Curtis, Brother Martin, live on Sports Nola, March 21st, tape delay WHNO, March 22nd. And then Brother Martin and Rummel, live on Sports Nola, March 28th, tape delayed on WHNO, March 29th. A couple of District 9-5A contests that should be very good ones, featuring three clear contenders in the Catholic League, along with Holy Cross and Jesuit for certain. And St. Thomas Aquinas does, in fact, go to the bullpen, and they're going to bring in Champ Artigues, who was already in the game. So he's established as the pitcher now in the game, and Artigues had been at shortstop. So he takes over on the mound. We'll check the other defensive change for you and have that for you coming up. But with that, we check in on Champ Artigues, who's making his first appearance of the season. Returning player from a year ago, junior, and obviously a guy whose name is synonymous with Southeastern Louisiana.
Yeah, his dad, J. Artigues, former head coach, now athletic director here at SLU. So baseball is in his blood. He's a high school shortstop, and nine times out of ten, the high school shortstop also has to pitch. So here's Champ Artigues on the bump here tonight.
Shortstop Alex Egan. Now they just basically switch positions. So Egan at short, and Artigues is on the mound, as Egan did not have it here this evening. Didn't get a lot of help either, though, to be honest with you. And he'll be back. He's a very good one. And now Artigues tries to keep it the way it is as he faces the heart of the order. Sam Smith leads it off. Takes it high for ball one. Smith is singled to drive home two, and he struck out. Outside, it's 2-0 as Clayton, Kyle Clayton, leads it off. Clayton is tripled and singled, to correct myself, with an RBI. Scorebook's a mess. Down and out, 3-0. I hate those type of games, man. You bat around, you erase, you fix, look at the wrong side. And here's the thing. I keep thinking St. Thomas Aquinas is the home team because we're in Hammond. I got to get over it.
It's kind of interesting, considering you passed the sign that tells you take a left to go to their school about 5 minutes away from here, but they're the visitor.
3-1 is a strike. It's 3-2 to Kyle Clayton, who had the booming triple in the first for an RBI, scored a run, singled again in the third, scored a run, and takes it just off the plate, ball four. Pretty close pitch, but Clayton knew it, and he trots to first with a leadoff walk, and again, that's the fourth straight inning that Holy Cross has had the leadoff man on. And it's hard to play that way if you're in the field. As the bullpen again readies for St. Thomas Aquinas, and once again it's Trey Malazzo who's loosening.
Well, this Holy Cross club is very talented. Had firsthand knowledge of that last summer when we played them in the American Legion Championship.
Runner goes. Pitch game. Down and away. Throw is not there. And a stolen base for Clayton. So Holy Cross stays aggressive.
They stay aggressive. They're not going to stop. That's how they want to play. They're using this as a chance to get better and start feeling better about themselves offensively. Another look at the speed of Clayton on the bases there.
He was actually looking back, Danny. He ended up short of the bag, and he was looking back on the play. You kind of wonder about that. Down and out. What that means is when you see a player looking back, you would assume the hit and run was on.
He was watching the ball through the hitting zone, absolutely. Could have been a missed sign or
1-1. Showed Bunt took it away, a breaking ball. 2-1 to Wiltz. Pretty interesting how Clayton did the pop-up slide and, almost got there. To short. Runner holds. Tough play. Safe at first. Infield hit for Wiltz. Ball was hit slowly to Artigues, and once he didn't come immediately to come get it, you knew it was going to be tough with Wiltz running.
Tough play for Egan there at short, just coming off the mound.
Right.
And infield hit there. And, you know, just going back to what I was just starting to mention a little while ago, this Holy Cross team in late July last summer, I'll tell you, they were as good as anybody you'd find at that point in the summertime. And this is a quality club, very good players, and you can bet that they're going to have something to say about that Division I select bracket state championship before it's all over.
Talked to several people, and in the Catholic League. They feel like they have the best players. 1-0 the count on Collette. And a wild pitch will advance the runners to second and third as the carnage continues. Right about now, Baron Morgan's just scratching his head. He said, who are these guys out there? It's not the team that I've seen to go 5-1.
Yeah, he was telling us before the game that, you know, they play really good defense. And he said he did say, I will give him this one. He did say, just because I told you that, we'll probably stink it up tonight.
Exactly.
He said he probably just put the mouth on him, and that looks to be true, unfortunately, for the Falcons.
You're going to blame us. We'll take it. Hit him with a pitch. What else can happen? Wild pitch. Hit batsman. Walk. Bases loaded. And nobody out once again for Holy Cross. They've had runners all over the bases. Ethan Mitchell could do something about it. He has walked and scored. Pop to the catcher. From the stretch, Artigues. This is ripped down the left field line. One run is home. Two runs will score. Ringing double, Ethan Mitchler. Holy Cross 11-4.
Mitchler just hit that ball about as hard as you can hit it. That ball was absolutely crushed down the left field line. The third baseman for St. Thomas Aquinas, Michael Dixon, did a nice job of just kind of touching it. It was a nice play just to touch it with the leather. But that thing had some steam on it. Here's another look. He turns on that thing and just shoots it down the left field line.
And another hit batsman as we return to live action. As hit by a pitch is Mickey Toscano. And there he is standing at first. Second hit batsman of the inning. Third hit batsman of the game. And once again, bases are loaded with nobody out. How many times have we said that? And a visit to the mound.
Looks like they're going to make a change. He just tapped his right arm, so that's going to be a short debut on the mound for Champ Artigues, who is pitching for the first time here tonight. And this is a tough game. Both of these teams are just up in Monroe. You know, you got to get back in town, and you're turning around and playing this one quick on a Monday. So it's a tough turnaround for these teams, and it just looks like the St. Thomas group isn't playing baseball the way they normally do here tonight.
No, they just came off of playing brilliantly in Monroe, winning three games. So when we return in a moment, we'll tell you all about the new pitcher for the Falcons as we continue on the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase on WHNO. Trey Malazzo comes on for St. Thomas Aquinas. A look at the numbers on Trey this year. Danny, 10 and a third innings pitched. One more hit than innings pitched and seven strikeouts.
Well, he's got some time on the mound, 10 and a third. That's a pretty good tally for this early in the year. So obviously a right-hander that the Falcons are going to look to use throughout the course of their season, getting some work here tonight in a midweek game, if you will. See that a lot at the college level, lots of arms thrown in the midweek, and kind of seeing the same tonight for St. Thomas Aquinas.
So with the bases loaded and nobody out, in the dirt, runner will not break, doesn't get that far away from the catcher, Smith, 1-0 to Rosano, and an RBI ground out in the third, he's 0-2.
Thank you.
from the stretch, high. So two balls, no strikes. And neither pitch has been close. One in the dirt, one way high. Infield in for the play at the plate. They can ill afford to give up much more. This is down the middle and ripped in the right for a base hit by Rosano. One run is home. They'll stop everybody else. Good idea. Right fielder shows a strong arm as Becerra. But a run is home, and it's 12-4. Rosano with a two RBI game, and that's his first hit of the year.
Nice job of pulling that one out in the right field for the RBI single. Cass Hargis with the smart move in the third base box of not taking a chance with the backside runner, stopping them, keeping the bases loaded, making sure there stays no outs on the board.
And now you get Nalesnik to the plate, top of the order, and that's way high. Two walks for Nalesnik, a run scored, he's 0-1. Took it down the middle, so it's 1-1. 12-4 Tigers, bottom of the fourth. And they have the bases loaded with nobody out.
Bases loaded, nowhere to put you if you're Cole Nalesnik. You're trying to zone in on something that you can really handle and give it a ride.
Way outside, 2-1.
It's a great spot to be in as a hitter with the bases loaded. If they can't throw you strikes, your team's scoring. If they throw you a strike, and you can do something with it. It's a significant part of a game.
Fouled it back, 2-2.
Trying to get something to the outfield. Whenever that infield's in, you're trying to get something to the outfield.
Two balls, two strikes, nobody out. And another. Down, so it's full 3-2. No room to put him on base. Gold ring on deck. 3-2 the count. Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. So Nalesnik fans for out number one. Big strikeout against a good hitter by Malazzo. And now Ashton Goldring, who's at a sacrifice, popped out, grounded out, has driven home a run. 0-2.
That's a big strikeout right there for St. Thomas Aquinas because it puts you in a position now if you can roll a ground ball, double play, get you out of this jam. Holy Cross with 12 runs on the board, just too shy of being up by 10. If they can get up by 10, they are just three outs away from ending this thing. So this is a situation where St. Thomas Aquinas really needs to get out of this.
Strike called, gets ahead of Goldring. Bounced it. Nice stop by Smith. 1-1. First six had reached in the inning, much like in the third. Three runs home, 12-4. Tigers threatening to add some more. One, one. Driven in the left center. That's going to play two. Holy Cross will take the 10-run lead. Lead runner will go to third, and it's a double. So a two-run double for Ashton Goldring, and Holy Cross has a 10-run lead at 14-4.
All right, chase the ball.
Three RBI game for Goldring now.
Goldring turned in that pitch, drives it out there into left center. A big hit there to put him up by 10. Holy Cross is now going to have a chance to end the game in the fifth inning via the 10-run rule if they can maintain that 10-run lead. Might be more, as they only have one out.
Right, and Timpany's had a big night with two hits and RBI, two runs scored, took a strike. He's also fanned as the scorebook gets messier by the moment. He 11 hits now for the Tigers. Down a ball, keeps the runners at second and third, does Smith. And a 1-1 count. Yeah, and certainly that's big insurance out there at second and third. If you're Holy Cross, you'd like to have a working margin going to that top of the fifth, trying to close this. And the 1-1, popped him up. That's going to be short left field. Left fielder on, and he can't get it off his glove. A runner's going to score. Another runner for third. He's safe, and it's now 15-4. And that's a ball that could have been caught.
When it rains, it pours here tonight for St. Thomas Aquinas. Just not playing very good defense. That was a ball that was up in the air for a long time. Somebody's got to get there. And the left fielder.
That's an error.
Kyle King not able to pull it in.
Well, that's an error, definite error. So as a result of the error, another run scores. I'm not sure the run could have scored as shallow as he was in left field if he caught that
ball.
Yeah,
I think they probably would have faked it at third.
Sure, it wouldn't have run. So that's an error.
Once it dropped down, it was time to take off.
It's 15-4, no RBI given, a ball down to Clayton. He's had the triple, single, 2-for-2, 3 runs scored, an RBI. Just one of those nights for St. Thomas Aquinas. Believe you me, they're much better than this. 1-1 to count on Clayton.
Well, this is exactly what the doctor ordered here tonight for Holy Cross. They needed a big offensive performance, and they're getting it right now. Double-digit runs, double-digit hits.
Putting on a show offensively and getting a lot of help from the opponent. And a major cut at that. Fouled it back. It's 1-2. They have some good-looking hitters, don't they?
Yeah, Clayton takes a hack. He gets all of his money's worth every time he swings the bat. He swings with bad intentions.
Ball and two strikes. Down the middle, this is hit to third. Off the glove of the third baseman. Runner scampers back, and everybody's safe. Wow.
Eric Ferry, you know who that is?
So, bases will be loaded yet again on a base hit by Clayton. They'll give him a hit. That's his third hit of the game.
Ended up being a really good base running play by Goldring down at third to find his way back to the base. And that caused the only play for St. Thomas to be across the diamond in no time after they knocked it down to have a chance at Clayton.
Another pitcher in the bullpen for St. Thomas Aquinas. Might see him given the circumstances. They just haven't had any answer offensively, stopping the Tigers or pitching or in the field, and we're going to get another change. So Malazzo's going to leave. We'll take the timeout. We'll tell you all about the new pitcher when we return on the first WC Bank Prep Showcase. Falcons will be the left-hander Blair Rodrigue, a sophomore, making his first appearance of the year. Right about now, he's probably saying, gee, thanks, coach. Based on the way his teams play. Look, the good news for St. Thomas Aquinas is it's just one game.
Yeah, and with the change, you know, in the playoffs this year, I was talking to Ronnie Cornick, the Holy Cross assistant, before the game, and you know, obviously they've liked to have gotten off to a little bit better start than they have. And I said, hey, you know, really, more so than ever, it's really all about you know, the progression throughout the season, getting better as the season goes along, because, you know, these teams know they're in the playoffs. Mm-hmm. So it's not like you're fighting like you used to be in the top 32 statewide. You know you're in the playoffs. So, you know, this season more than ever, it's really about coaching your guys up and trying to be as good as you can be at the end of the season, as obviously Cass Hargis had told his runner to put the brakes on. They're not trying to run up the score here because they could have scored another run
easy.
Right there.
Yeah, that was your clearly a wild pitch. And this young man, Rodriguez, was having trouble getting the ball to the plate in warm-ups, and that's continued with his first two pitches here, and it's 2-0. Good move by the shortstop to come in and have war with the shortstops, Artigues, now as they move people around. Once again, changed him up and popped him up. Might get an out over near the third baseline and caught. So that's the second out. It's a big out. You got a chance to get out of this, only down 11. Wiltz. On an off-speed pitch, popped out, and now Collette bats.
Well, you're trying to keep it manageable. Holy Cross only has to get three outs in the top of the fifth if St. Thomas isn't able to score two runs at this point. So you're trying to keep it manageable if you're St. Thomas. You're trying to keep the game going. You could have done that. I wanted
to say it. Pitch on the way. Popped him up. Catcher over. Might have a play near the dugout, and it comes back, and nobody catches it. And it's been that type of game for St. Thomas Aquinas. Well, if you're looking at stars of the game, Kyle Clayton's 3-for-3, a booming triple. He scored three times, an RBI as well. He's obviously been very good for Holy Cross in this game. Ashton Goldring's driven in three. They've got 12 hits. Chris Collette here is a double, an RBI to his credit, scored twice. Just reached out for that one. Off speed, fouled it back, 0-2.
Soft toss and lefties got him out on their front foot a little bit right here.
I'm going to say the same thing.
Having trouble making the adjustment.
No balls and two strikes. Runners on every base with two outs. Here it is. Pops some foul on a play. Tried to wait on that one and ended up behind it, holding 0-2. Another good-looking hitter, Kyle Collette. We're mentioning Nor Holy Cross's batting averages coming in. They're better than that. They faced good pitching, really good opposition this year. Averages climbing tonight. That ball's driven to left, but it's hooking foul. So Collette, that time, hammers it, but out in front, and it holds 0-2. It's on the kitten. Runners again will lead from every base. Rodriguez brings it. Reached out and fouled it back. That pitch was out of the zone. Collette remaining aggressive. Well, it was a key to the game. We said it. Holy Cross has lived up to it with spades, hasn't they?
They sure have. And this is, like I've said throughout the broadcast, something that Cass Hargis was really looking for tonight, just to get themselves
going. That's driven
going.
Down a left field line. Left fielder on the run is there. And this ball is caught. So this time, caught by King to end the inning. Stranding, the bases loaded. Going to the fifth, last chance for STA, trailing 15-4. This portion of the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase is presented by Gibbs Construction, a leader in the construction industry in Louisiana and in the Gulf Coast for more than 35 years. Transforming dreams, visions, and plans into reality. Gibbs Construction. Ian Buras is done for the day. Pitched four innings, allowed just one hit. Four runs, three of those earned, and stands to win this one. Kyle Clayton will get the ball to try to close it out if he possibly can. It's his first appearance of the year, but he can pitch, Danny.
Yeah, he sure can. He can bring it. Had a great summer for Holy Cross in American Legion play with Ponsteins. Going to Nicholls State. He's planning on pitching there in Thibodeau, so he's a good arm. Needs to get himself going. Hasn't gotten a chance to throw a lot. Had a little bit of a back issue early in the year, but I think he's better and ready to get back on the mound and get going. And he's a shutdown type arm for Holy Cross once they get him back in form.
Sam Smith will lead it off. Last chance for St. Thomas Aquinas. He'll be followed by Trey Malazzo and Alex Egan against Clayton. Here in the top of the fifth inning, Smith has singled home a pair of runs, one for two. Took a hot one for a strike. Another fastball, a good one, strike call. Fastball getting there pretty good from Clayton and quickly ahead 0-2. And just blew him away. Good morning, good afternoon, good night, one gone.
That's all it takes right there. Three good fastballs from Kyle Clayton, and we've got out number one on the board. Raring back and bringing it.
Smart pitch, 0-2. Get him to chase. Malazzo is grounded out, has a sacrifice just off the outside edge. Another good fastball. Clayton working quickly, 2-0. Buras did walk three and hit two, so the control was the only issue. They didn't hit him. Strike over the outside edge, 2-1. But that's been the issue for Holy Cross pitching early this year is control. Good pitch of the knees, 2-2. All fastballs thus far from Clayton. Likely to throw another here. Does. See you later. Two gone, and St. Thomas Aquinas is down to its last out.
Good fastball in the outer part of the plate there by Clayton to put him away. Got that closer mentality right here. Raring back and bringing it. Put that fastball in a perfect spot.
Clayton misses to Egan. He's popped out, grounded out. Late on the fastball, and it's 1-1. And now it's 2-1. And this is driven to right side, should end the game. The right fielder's there and putting it away for Holy Cross is Mitchler. And the Holy Cross Tigers have dismissed St. Thomas Aquinas in demonstrative fashion, 15-4. Back with our post game in a moment on the first NBC Bank Prep Showcase on WHNO TV 20. Holy Cross. Holy Cross defeats St. Thomas Aquinas by the score of 15-4. Let's check in with Danny Ream with the winners.
All right, thanks, Ken. Down here with Cass Hodges, head coach of the Holy Cross Tigers. Coach, we were talking before. You wanted to get off to a better start, and you definitely did that here tonight.
We did, and Ian Buehr's starting pitcher gave us a chance to do that by going out, getting a quick 1-2-3 inning in the first, and allowed our offense to kind of not play from ahead, but we've started in the hole the last four games, and it was nice to get out to a lead, start fast, and be able to run our offense throughout the game the way that we can.
Let's talk about the third inning. In the top of the third, you give up the four spot, you lose the lead. You had to be proud of the way your team responded immediately in the bottom half of the inning, putting the sixth spot up.
I was, and the thing that I'm most proud of is before we even got back into the dugout, the guys were telling each other, guys, we're going to be all right, we're going to be all right. Is that's one thing that we talked about coming into tonight. In the past, we kind of let one pitch affect the next. Tonight, we didn't do that, and that was evident there in the third inning. They put up a four spot, and it didn't faze us at all. We went back to work on offense and grabbed the lead right back from them.
All right, Coach, thanks. Here with Kyle Clayton. Kyle, big night at the plate, 3-for-3. You were feeling it, seeing it good?
Oh, yeah, no doubt. I was seeing fastball all the way through, just stay back and hit a line drive through the middle, and just, that's all we do.
All right, and then you got to get on the mound for the first time this year. How did that feel? You were throwing pretty hard.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I've been itching to get on the mound. I've been itching Coach Cass saying, let me get on the mound all weekend, like in Monroe. And so he finally let me get a little in, and felt real good.
All right, well, a good night here in Hammond for the Holy Cross Tigers. They will be a team to watch in a Division I select bracket. Back to you, Ken.
All right, Danny, thank you. Great job. Back to put a wrap in just a moment. 15-4, Holy Cross the winner over St. Thomas Aquinas. Holy Cross, a convincing win over St. Thomas Aquinas, 15-4 to improve to 5-5 on the year. And the Falcons drop to 5-2 with the defeat. Strawberry Stadium, the site of many good football games here on the campus of Southeastern Louisiana. And a good performance in baseball by Holy Cross, the home team, though visiting here tonight in Hammond. Thanks for joining us. Our baseball coverage resumes on March 21st with the District 9-5A opener between John Curtis Christian and Brother Martin. Catch it live on SportsNola.com or watch the tape delay broadcast the next day at 4:30 on WHNO. For Danny Ream and our entire WHNO crew, I'm Ken Trahan. Once again, your final score, Holy Cross 15, St. Thomas Aquinas 4. For Danny and Lenny and the crew, I'm Kenny. Thanks for joining us. Be a good sport. God bless you one and all. Bounding third and heading home. So long.